Hi, this is David from Minute Earth, and I've got a bone to pick with anatomy textbooks. Almost all of them say that you have exactly 206 bones in your body, 28 in your skull, 64 in your arms, 52 in your trunk, and 62 in your legs. But those textbooks are way too sure of themselves. That's not just because there are plenty of people born without legs or with extra fingers or whatever. It's also that these books fail to account for the cartilage to bone spectrum. Our entire skeletons start out as cartilage. As we grow, some of that cartilage gets surrounded by special cells that lay down a dense tissue full of calcium, turning it to bone. When we're babies, only the very middle and the two ends of some of our bones have actually turned to bone. And since textbooks usually define individual bones as uninterrupted areas of calcium tissue, they consider babies to have way more bones than adults. Okay, so that's a little weird. But what's even weirder is that textbooks aren't consistent about the way they count bones. Fused bones in certain regions of the body, like in our skulls, seem to be more likely to get counted than others. Our brain case, for example, gets fused together in sutures by the age of 2 as all that cartilage turns to bone. Despite that fusion, though, our textbooks still consider our adult upper skulls to be 22 different bones. Meanwhile, our somewhat useless tailbone fuses in a similar way, but our textbooks count it as only one bone. This is even more ridiculous when you consider that most people's tailbones aren't actually totally fused in the first place. And those textbooks also fail to acknowledge that there are lots of places in our bodies where, for whatever reason, some people convert cartilage to bone and other people don't. 30% of people have calcified at least one extra bean-sized bone behind their knees. 20% of people have an extra bone as part of their little toe. And 10% of us have an extra bone in our wrist. One guy was found to have made an extra 42 bones in his body, and he didn't even know about it until he got x-rayed. None of those bones are counted in the 206 we're used to, even though we do count even tinier, more important bones, like the stapes in our middle ear. If your body has decided to bone up, or even bone down, compared to the supposed 206 standard, you might not even know without getting a full body x-ray. But that spectrum does illustrate yet another bit of the incredible variation that exists in our species. Diversity that extends all the way down to our bones. And did you know that our bones do more than just make up our skeleton? They also send calcium to the heart so it can keep pumping away, which you can learn about in our brand new show called Minute Body, in which we take you on a minute-long tour of a different body part in every episode. We just launched it on Nebula, a new streaming platform that we are helping to build alongside many of our other favorite educational creators. And the best way to get Nebula is to sign up for CuriosityStream, which has tons of great streaming science documentaries, including my current favorite, Ancient Earth. If you sign up for a free one-month trial at curiositystream.com/minute, you will get a Nebula subscription, including Minute Body, bundled in for free. So go to curiositystream.com/minute and get watching today.